taste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. This is my story. My song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture now burst on my sight. Angels descending, ring from above, echoes of mercy, whispers of love. This is my story. This is my song.
My soul, praising Thank you. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair. When the saved of earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
is called up yonder.
When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. On that bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise and the glory of his resurrection share, when his chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the skies and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Called up yonder.
When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Will overspread the sky, but when travel that will be when we all see Jesus. We'll sing and shout the victory. Let us then be true and faithful, trusting, serving every day. Just one glimpse of Him in glory will the toils of life repay. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Onward to the prize before us, soon His beauty we'll behold. Soon the pearly gates will open, we shall tread the streets of gold. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of His Spirit, in His blood.
This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song. Savior, all the day long.
When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows I see billows roll, whatever I love, thou hast taught me to say,
When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair. When the saved of earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
is called up yonder,
when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
On that bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise and the glory of his resurrection share, when his chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the skies, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll
up yonder,
when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Sing his mercy and his grace. In the mansions bright and blessed, he'll prepare for us a place.
When we all
get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be.
When we all
see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. We walk the pilgrim pathway, clouds will overspread the sky.
But when traveling days are over, not a shadow, not a sigh.
When we all
get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be.
When we all
see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory.
Let us then be true and faithful, trusting, serving every day. Just one glimpse of Him in glory will the toil of life repay.
When we all
get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be.
When we all
see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Onward to the prize before us, soon His beauty we'll behold. Soon the pearly gates will open, we shall tread the streets of gold.
When we all
get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be.
When we all
see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of His Spirit, in His blood.
This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song.
In His love.
This is my
I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand on the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin worms destroy this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God, whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold, and not another. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore will we not fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof. Verily, verily, I say unto you, the hour is coming, and now is, when the dead shall hear the voice of the Son of God, and they that hear shall live. I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have fought the good fight. I have finished my course, I have kept the faith. Henceforth there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord and not me only, but unto all them also that love his appearing. Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. I wish to take this opportunity on behalf of the Love of the Marshall families, Summerlatch families, to welcome you to this ongoing service as we offer thanks to God for the life and service and witness of Haldane over these past 56 years. We trust that this service would also serve as a means of reflection, reassessment for us, as we too reflect on our own journey, with the understanding that we too will pass this way, and grant that we too would so order our steps, so that like the Apostle Paul, we can say that we have fought the good fight, finished the course, and kept the faith. Let us pray. O God of life, as we have learned to do in all our experiences, we come to thee in the hour of death. We know that thou dost love us, and that thou canst turn even the shadow of death into the light of morning. Help us now to wait before thee with reverent and submissive hearts. Make this a time of opening our eyes and our understanding, and a time of admonition to our hearts and souls. Bless all those who feel this sorrow most keenly, and cause the bonds of Christian love to bind us closer together, so that we may share with them that spiritual strength and that faith in God which is ours, through the love of Christ, in whose name we pray. Amen. Please remain standing as we sing the first hymn, A Wonderful Savior, in Jesus my Lord.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His prayer shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make a boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. O magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he heard me, and delivered me from all my fears. They looked unto him, and were enlightened, and their faces were not ashamed. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard him, and saved him out of all his troubles. The angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear him, and delivereth them. O taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusteth in him. O fear the Lord, ye his saints, for there is no want to them that fear him. The young lions do lack and suffer hunger, but they that seek the Lord shall not want any good thing. Come, ye children, hearken unto me. I will teach you the fear of the Lord. What man is he that desireth life, and loveth many days, that he may see good? Keep thy tongue from evil, and thy lips from speaking guile. Depart from evil, and do good. Seek peace, and pursue it. The eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and his ears are unto their cry. The face of the Lord is against them that do evil, to cut off the remembrance of them from the earth. The righteous cry, and the Lord heareth, and delivereth them out of all their troubles. The Lord is high unto them that are of a broken heart, and saveth such as be of a contrite spirit. Many are the affections, are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivereth him out of them all. He keepeth all his bones, not one of them is broken. Evil shall slay the wicked, and they that hate the righteous shall be desolate. The Lord redeemeth the soul of his servants, and none of them that trust in him shall be desolate. Here is the reading.
Thank you, Daniel. We now have a solo followed by the eulogy and then the New Testament reading. And I'll come back. When I come back to you, we'll join together in singing the hymn, Will Your Anchor Hold.
Sails go on. born on November 25, 1965, and was the eldest of four children born to her parents, Anthony and Marjorie Lovell of Chimborazo in the parish of St. Joseph. She received a sound education at
Bernard's Primary School and St. Michael's Secondary. At the tertiary level, she undertook specialized courses in several disciplines and brought these skills to bear in her employment in various establishments, including her family business, which she worked hard to build from scratch into a viable business entity. From an early age, Haldane demonstrated excellent leadership skills. I can vividly recall how she readily assumed responsibility for us, my sister Maureen, my late brother Glenmar, and me, during the vacation periods while our parents went off to work. She would fry bakes in the morning, and during the day, cook plain rice or macaroni, which was often adorned with butter and ketchup. Those were simple days marked by contentment. Even though most of the bakes were burnt, and sometimes the grain of rice was not too soft, we ate what she prepared joyfully, since we were trained by our parents to be thankful and appreciative of what was set before us. Like the Arfish country household, and long before the prevalence of the various brands adorning our supermarket shelves, Haldane's weekly task was also the making of seasoning on Saturdays for the preparation of the meat for the Sunday meal. She similarly did this task with great pleasure, and with time became quite proficient in this undertaking. Consequently, I also developed a love for this art and would frequently share some with her during our adult years. She often commended me for the taste and indicated that it went well with everything, including chewing gum. And yes, she tried it with that too. At a personal level, Haldane was a beautiful person, both externally and internally. She made friends easily, was a great communicator, and was loved by all. One cousin described her thus: Haldane always had a big personality, a laugh, a smile, and a mischievous twinkle in her eyes. She was both physically beautiful and authentic, a rare combination. Haldane gave birth to three handsome sons, Daniel, Joshua, and Shakar, who were the offspring of her marriage. These boys, now adult young men, were her absolute pride and joy. Almost everywhere she went, at least one, if not all of them, would be in her company. Additionally, she was very devoted to her paternal obligations and ensured that her children were well cared for physically, emotionally, and spiritually. Spiritual nurture and church attendance were essential parts of that process. As one of the pastors in her assembly, they were also the beneficiary of her general pastoral ministry as well. In fact, she loved her congregation immensely and cared for each member as she would her own family. Unfortunately, life does not always go as planned. Yet we take great comfort in Romans 8:28, which says, "All things work together for the good of those who love God and are called according to his purpose." Haldane was diagnosed with dementia at age 48. Mommy and Daddy took great care of her. They were assisted by my cousin Nicole. But her condition got progressively worse, and we had to make the difficult decision to place her in a private care facility. What blessed our hearts as a family was the fact that even at the lowest points in her life, when she could barely talk or walk, the one thing that she could still do was sing spiritual hymns and songs and make melody in her heart unto the Lord. Indeed, it was evident that God was yet ministering to her soul, and she was still communicating with her Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. God loved Haldane to the end, and she loved him in return. Haldane was called to her eternal rest on Saturday, October 8th, following 6 weeks as a patient in the Queen Elizabeth Hospital. I wish on behalf of her sons, parents, siblings, nieces, nephews, aunts and uncles, and extended members of the family to extend my sincerest appreciation to the doctors and nurses of Ward C10 for their exceptional care of my sister during those final weeks of her life. Similar expressions are also extended to the management and staff of Roseville Nursing Home, where she resided for the past 9 months. Haldane Ramona Marshall's life was not lived in vain. If you knew her, you were blessed. If you did not know her, then get to know her, God. She leaves to mourn her sons, Daniel, Joshua, and Shakar. Parents, Anthony and Marjorie Lovell. Siblings, Maureen and Allison. Nieces and nephews, and several other relatives and friends. You are gone, but you will never be forgotten. You will forever be in our hearts. Until we meet again, may you rest in peace and rise in glory.
Good afternoon. This scripture reading will be taken from Romans 8, verses 31 to 39. What shall we then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifieth. Who is he that condemneth? It is Christ that died, yea, rather, that is risen again, who is even at the right hand of God, who also maketh intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Here ends the Bible reading.
Just in case you joined us after we started, whether here in sanctuary or online, we welcome you to this homegoing Thanksgiving service for her family and friend, Haldane Ramona Marshall. We certainly recognize several ministers of religion. I cannot make it clearly if this is the Honorable Attorney General, is it? Happy to see you. Happy to see you, sir. We welcome you and all the other relatives and friends, former colleagues. We welcome you to this service. Please stand as we sing the hymn before the sermon, Will Your Anchor Hold?
Oh,
to the Old Testament lesson which was read, and for the time being I'll just read verse 8. O taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusteth in him. Let us pray. May the words of our mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our redeemer. Amen. Be seated. Today, any time available to me, I would like to share with you on what I'm simply calling a divine invitation. A divine invitation. This psalm was penned by the psalmist in what I may consider peculiar circumstances. The details of which are not highlighted in the psalm itself. David was forced to flee from his country because of the rage of Saul, who was bent on killing him. And he, David, sought shelter in the land of the Philistines, which to some extent was enemy territory. And we're told that when it was discovered that David was there, he was summoned before the king. And out of sheer self-preservation and to guarantee his own safety, right in the presence of the king, David started to act like a madman. He started to act as though he was insane. He understood very well the consequences if they had determined that he was a spy who was there with less than wholesome intentions to compromise their own security. He understood the consequences quite well. And so the result was that David was dismissed from the presence of the king, and his life, which was momentarily threatened, was again preserved by God. Amen. This evening in this homegoing service, we are more concerned with the messages and the sentiments expressed by the psalmist in this psalm rather than the self-preservation methodology adopted by David, and which in itself can lend to much debate and discussion. Certainly beyond a shadow of a doubt, there was nothing inept or insane or incoherent about the sentiments and indeed the deep message and even messages expressed by the psalmist in this beautiful psalm, which not only, brothers and sisters, gives us some meaningful insight concerning our God, but it also highlights and mirrors firsthand some of David's own experiences with his God, this Almighty God. Let me say to you up front that it is one thing to hear about God or to read about God. It is another to know God, to know him experientially. And it is this real and experiential knowledge of God that really make the difference when we are faced with disappointments, when we are faced with difficulties, when we are faced with danger and even ultimately when we are faced with death. Undoubtedly, the psalmist invites us to share in the confidence and the joys even that such a relationship with God brings. And so as I share with you briefly today on the topic, a divine invitation, there are three elements of this invitation which I wish to highlight and to impress upon you as seen through the lenses of the psalmist David. Firstly, there is God's invitation to taste me. Taste me. Verse 8, the psalmist said, "Taste and see that the Lord is good." It is said that the true test of the pudding is in the eating. The cake may look good and smell good, but may not necessarily taste good. And of course, pardon my bias here, but any cake from Nicholas Bakery or Carter's Bakery not only look good and smell good, but taste exceptionally good as well. I wish to take this opportunity to reinforce the fact and to suggest to you very strongly that the goodness of God is synonymous with the very nature and the character of God. In fact, it is one of his essential attributes. He is indeed a good God. If God has been good to you, just raise your hand and say, "Praise the Lord, somebody." He's a good God. One writer said, and I quote, "Though we may get our hearts broken from the effects of sin in this in-between time, God's goodness will eventually set the world right. In the meantime, we must hold fast to the truth of God and his unchanging nature. God is good. His plans are good. His requirements are good. His salvation is good. His grace is good. His forgiveness is good. His restoration is good." End of quote. Oh, praise the Lord. And the truth is, brothers and sisters, the truth is, all he deserves from us is that we give him that opportunity to prove his goodness and to make that essential difference in our lives. To his people through the prophet Jeremiah in chapter 29 and verse 11, he states, and I quote, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." Amen. I'm tempted to say, somebody say a hope and a future. Hope and a future. And even when we are grounded through sickness, through unforeseen circumstances, as Haldane was, in the peak of her life at age 48, crippled through sickness, literally, it did not destroy her confidence and her commitment to God. And even as the eulogist, her sister Allison, said, when she could no longer walk or talk, what still came out periodically from her soul, from her innermost being, were songs and hymns as she made music and melody in her heart unto the Lord. Another writer said, and I wish to quote this, believers in Jesus experience this of God's goodness and grace when we observe the beauty of his creation or recognize his blessings of provision, protection, and care. We taste and see his goodness when we contemplate his holiness and infinite righteousness. We delight in his goodness when we appreciate the cost of Christ's sacrifice for our salvation. End of quote. But that source, and I must include this, goes on to further state, to taste and see that the Lord is good, we must trust God and seek him as our sole source of protection. The only genuinely taste and see that the Lord is good is to put the matter to the test, to try and experience his goodness for ourselves. End of quote. Indeed, brothers and sisters, the psalmist proved God. The psalmist proved the faithfulness of God over and over and over again. And this was the same psalmist who only lived to 70 years. He was king at the age of 30, and he reigned for about 40 years. This is the same psalmist who in that beautiful psalm said, I was young, and now I am old, yet have I not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed break bread. Oh, hallelujah. What confidence and consolation. What comfort today to know that our God is with us always through the varying things of life, the stages of life. When life throws at us, it twists and turns. God is with us. He will never leave us nor forsake us, he said. He will be with us always, even unto the end. Taste me. Taste me, a divine invitation. But secondly, I hear God saying to us, take refuge in me. Amen. Take refuge in me. I'm going to use a corroborating text, Psalm 46, verse 1. God is what? God is our refuge and strength. God is our present help in trouble. And I wish to spend just a minute or two on this present help element. You see, when things do not turn out as planned, God is present. When disappointments in life come, God is present. Oh, hallelujah. Nothing at all that impacts upon us is outside of the realm of God's reach and God's intervention. And even when we ask for his goodness, proclaim his goodness in praise, God should get to know him. And my friends, occasions like these are important occasions for us to be reflective and to be introspective. And to come to the reality that we too will pass this way one day. And that essentially it is what is done for Christ that will matter most. Because each one of us has to stand before God to give him an account of our stewardship. And I trust today that we will so order our steps and we will so conduct our lives. And we will so live in faith. That as we stand before Almighty God, we would hear those words, Beautiful words of assurance. Well done, good and faithful servant. Thou hast been faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many things. Into the joy of thy Lord. On my own behalf and on behalf of my family and on behalf of our General Board of Administration of the Western Homes Church across the Caribbean, and certainly on behalf of these ministers gathered here, some are not from our assembly but across the Christian Church, we extend to you our prayerful support in this our time of loss. Please bow your heads for a minute of quiet reflection. Please stand as together we affirm our commitment to the Christian faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed as found on page 4. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered unto Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again, he ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father.
Spirit be with us all now and forever. Amen. Amen. Please remain silent for your recession.
Are over, not a shadow, not a sign. rejoicing that will be when we all see Jesus. We'll sing and shout the victory. Let us then be true and faithful, trusting, serving every day. Just one glimpse of Him in glory will the toils of life repay. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Onward to the prize before us, soon His beauty we'll behold. Soon the pearly gates will open, we shall tread the streets of gold. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of His Spirit, washed in His blood.
This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song.
His love.
This is my
looking for the resurrection and the life of the world to come through Lord, Lord Jesus Christ. And whose second coming, the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed, and shall be made like unto his glorious body, according to the mighty working whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself.
Thank you.
and keep you, make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you his peace. Sing along this night.
To the islands of the sea.
Thank you.
down, please. Okay, before the benediction, we just want to express thanks to you on behalf of the family for coming and sharing in this service and interment. Special thanks to the funeral director, the ushers, musicians, and all the persons who participated in the service. We would ask you to continue to pray for the family in the weeks and months ahead. May God bless you. Let us pray. Now the God of peace that brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. Good evening, everyone.